Honor Club, where honor is real.
All right, we are back here on the ROH Strong podcast. As you heard before we went to the break, Vincent wanted to be a part of it today and apparently has something he wants to say to Matt. Vincent, welcome to the show. The floor is yours.
Man, we can make an announcement to all the four district personnel that all work for us.
Hey, Kevin.
Yes.
How are you, man?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. You know, you are one hell of a guy. One hell of a guy. Man of the people. Chaotic Idol Matt Tavern.
Jesus Christ. What, you have nothing to do today, dude? Like,
Listen to Hard Daddy. Listen to Hard Daddy while he talks, man. You know, I listened to that whole entire podcast. And the things that stuck out the most, Taven, is Ring of Honor, if they were more successful, that means more stuff for you. You know, and then back to the college days, you know, I wanted to be a wrestler because I'll only worry about myself. I couldn't help to hear you constantly talk about you.
Yeah, the podcast is about me.
Taven, that's the thing, man.
It's
always about you. What you did, for who you did it for, how things benefit you, man. You and people like you are the problem. I can deal with sick and selfish people. Actually, I might be the most sick and selfish one of them all, but your lack of self-awareness, Taven, that's the problem. And people like you is what makes my road, my journey, so much more clear.
My lack of self-awareness. You are absolutely clueless. So, you know, like you know that everything that we've been through is on the internet. People can go look it up. Your daughter, I want you to know that Autumn one day is going to be able to look at everything that's happened. She's going to look at the fact that I brought you into Ring of Honor, that we traveled the world together, and then after everything that I've done for you, you were that big of a scumbag that you would turn your back on me. Your own daughter will know that you are that big of a scumbag. So, like, whatever. You will have to live with that till the day you die.
Taven, the eyes are useless when the mind is blind. I was a hostage with you. That's all I was. Just a political prisoner. I still am, in a way, with Ring of Honor. They don't put me on their podcast. They don't put me in the center of their flyers. They're all a bunch of liars. You're all lying. You're all lying for your jobs and your positions, trying to protect that phony thing you call you. And that's what you are, Taven. You're phony. You are now, all of a sudden, you're a man of the people. What happened to Matt Taven? Now all of a sudden he wants to become friends with all his fans and kiss up to them on social media. Social media, Taven, I notice you like to be funny on social media. Being funny is not going to save you. I know you like to be humorous, just like your friend Dalton Castle. But, you know, Taven, the truth is only dangerous if it can inflict injury. And you haven't injured me. It's over. I won. This battle is over, my friend. And I just wanted to let you know that. It is possible to be a puppet on a string without even realizing. You know what, Kevin? Let me tell you a story. I didn't go to college like Taven.
Are we going to let this guy talk all day?
Yeah. I didn't go to school like Taven. Taven was my college, but what he didn't realize is I was the teacher. See, I met Taven over 10 years ago. I saw a 6'2", athletic, in-shape guy. I knew he was going somewhere, and I saw that he had an open seat in the wagon, so what I did is I jumped in. He did all the driving. He did all the talking. When I said, Taven, get me in the Ring of Honor, he said, I'm trying. I'm trying. I said, Taven, get me in the Ring of Honor. He said, Vincent, I'm trying. I'm trying. And then what happened? Boom, I get a match for the world championship against Jay Lethal. 2 weeks later, Kevin calls me, and he says, Vincent, we want you to be a part of Ring of Honor. So Taven, listen to me. I was the leader. He was the messenger. You dig what I'm saying?
My God, you are so delusional. Vinny, you are unbelievably delusional. And yes, it's all about me still, because honestly, if it wasn't for me, none of this, your little speech, your little soliloquy, no one would ever hear it. Because Vinny, when you do something, no one cares about it. That's why every time that you do anything of any importance is because you're stealing my spotlight. Everything that I worked for, everything that I've done for the last 12 years that you had nothing to do with. What you had to do with was me literally picking you up and drag across the world. You were useless, you were luggage, and I made you who you are today.
And Taven, you talk about loyalty. You talk about loyalty. I heard you mention the word loyalty in this podcast. But let's get a little deeper with the loyalty thing. You brought in myself and TK Orion as the kingdom. And then it became Matt Taven and the kingdom. So I had to do something about it. And I did. I got rid of one guy out of the company completely. And now I'm working on the other. You dig what I'm saying? So that Jay Lethal, I wouldn't say Jay Lethal was your last hurdle. You're still stuck in the mud. You're still stuck in the mud that you mentioned earlier. And you said this: sometimes it's my own stupidness not learning from my old mistakes. Well, you're going to learn from this one, and then finally you can go and pick the brain of Jesus like you want to.
Like, who do you think you're talking to? You think you're talking to a guy that doesn't know you? Like, you're thinking you're talking to someone that has no idea who you are for your entire life. I can see right through all this phoniness. All right. I know exactly who you are. You just don't seem to realize that I am everything. I am everything that the horror dad is because of me. The fact that you're too jealous to realize to say thank you. All you need to do is say thank you. When I first brought you in, I said I created the kingdom. I reformed the kingdom in my own image. Okay. Don't ever get it twisted. It was always about me and the kingdom. Matt Taven and the kingdom. And then when I won the title at Madison Square Garden, you were overwhelmed with jealousy. You couldn't take it. You couldn't be happy for the guy that stuck his neck out for you and made sure your daughter had food on her table. That was me, all right? And you couldn't be happy for that guy and said you want to stab him in the back. That makes you the ultimate dirtbag. I sleep perfectly fine at night. And I'm telling you, Vinny, when I see you, it is not going to be good. All right, I have these scars on my knee and my ankle, and you think that it's all fun and games, but I guarantee you it will be nothing compared to what I do to you,
Vincent, we got to wrap this. We have to wrap this up. You asked for an opportunity to speak to Taven, I gave it to you. You can have. Is there anything you want to say because we need to wrap up?
Just remember, Taven, just like you said, this is a mental game. Remember that.
Okay.
I will remember that, Vinny. But the thing is, I'm a lot smarter than you. So let's play any mental game you want.